And Adam knew his wife again, and she bore a son and called his name Seth. For God said, she had appointed me another Seth instead of Abel, whom Cain slew. And to Seth, to him also there was born a son, and he called his name Enos. Then began men to call upon the name of the Lord. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. Sit down balanduciously on your enemy's head without apology, and tell your neighbor, you are glad to sit next to me. I am not hearing you well. Say, neighbor, you are sitting next to a miracle. I feel you can say it better. Say, neighbor, you are sitting next to a miracle. A message for today is titled, It Is Not Over. It is not over. I just want to exhort you briefly, then we go into some deep things today. It is not over. God sent me here to somebody that I've given up. God sent me here to somebody that some people have given up about you. God sent me here to somebody that everybody have said it cannot happen. God sent me here to somebody that you are just packing your bag and you are about to go. And I heard in my ear to say to you, it is not over. God sent me to somebody who have lost your job and you feel that is the end of the world. Daddy just said to my right ear to say to you, it is not over. God sent me to somebody that have received a medical verdict and they said to you, you can never have a child and that you have entered your menopause. I just heard in my right ear, it is not over. Am I talking to somebody here? God sent me to somebody here who had already been in the graveyard and the tomb has been rolled and the stone has been closed like Lazarus. And they said, by this time he stinketh. The Lord said, I should tell you, it is not over. I thought somebody is hearing the sound of my voice. Say, it is not over. I don't know how many of you are hearing the sound of my voice. It is not over. I say it is not over. I say it is not over. I say it is not over. They have given up about you and they said, you can't have a baby. But I have a good news for you, sister. It is not over. Am I talking to somebody here? They demolished your house, they sacked you, and they told you there is no hope. But Daddy just spoke to my ear, and he said, say to that person, it is not over. It is not over. It is not over until it is over. There is a hope for a living dog than a dead lion. There is a hope. I hear there is a hope. I am here to preach to a pastor that your members have conspired and your leaders have conspired, and it's like the church is about to close. You felt that there is no hope. Daddy just spoke to my ear to say to you, it is not over with you in that city. You are about to raise your head. You are about to walk like a fire. You are about to walk like a tsunami. You are about to erupt like a volcanic eruption. There's something here. I hear in my right ear, it is not over. Am I prophesying to somebody here? Mayandaya badayanda bayandaya pariko shaba. I prophesy, it is not over. I'm talking to somebody here that the devil said your marriage is over. It is not over. I'm talking to somebody here that your hope has been shattered. It is not over. I'm talking to ministries here that have been shattered. It is not over. I'm talking to political careers here that have been shattered. It is not over. I'm talking to that brother, to that sister. You have cried, and the tears means hopelessness. But in the midst of your hope, there is about to be hope. the midst of your hopelessness, there is about to be hope. In the midst of your disappointment, there is about to be appointment. I preach here, I prophesy, it is not over. Am I talking to somebody here? It is not over. It is not over in my business. It is not over in my ministry. It is not over in my marriage. It is not over in my womb. It is not over about bearing children. It is not over. Enemies, you must have fought me yesterday, but I have a good news for you. It is not over. I am bouncing back. I am coming back with fire. Am I talking to somebody here? David said, rejoice not over me, my enemy, for when I fall higher, I shall surely rise. It is not over. Lift up your leg and shout fire. Lift a leg and shout fire, yeah, 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 yeah. Hey! 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 Shout fire! It is not over. It is not over. It is not over. Enemy from my father's house, it is not over. Political enemies, it is not over. Enemy of my ministry, it is not over. Wrong concluders, it is not over. You thought it is over, it is not over. I might be buried, but I'm alive. I might be buried, but I'm alive. It is not over. My members must have scattered. It is not over. I am coming back with the sky. It is not over. Powers of darkness, it is not over. No retreat, no surrender. No retreat, no surrender. It is not over. I am taking over. I am taking over. Because it's not over. Can somebody shout fire? Shout fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hey! Hey! Lift up your leg and shout fire. Shout fire. Hey! Sit down. This was the story of a woman who was the first woman on earth. Her name is Eve. Special woman. A woman of grace. And her husband called Adam, meaning mankind. And her two sons. You will not understand this text until I show you the back view or the backdrop of this story. I just want us to rewind our mind. What happened before she got here to give birth to Seth? And something happened. The Bible makes us to understand that when man sinned in the Garden of Eden through the deception of the serpent, and man lost his authority, God placed curse on man. And what was the curse? Prior to that time, the prophetic and scriptural instruction that God gave to man is that of all fruit in the garden, you must not eat that one in the middle of the garden. And the one in the middle of the garden is dedicated to me. And the day you eat that fruit, you shall die. And because the serpent made the devil make Adam to eat the fruit, so man lost the authority. And Adam and Eve were aware of the scriptural implication or the instructional implication that the day you eat from that fruit, you shall die. Follow me. And so when Adam ate from that fruit, and Eve, she ate from that fruit, it was clear to them that they were going to die. Now, you might not understand what this means. Adam does not understand
Even thought the time you are going to die, they don't understand what it means to die. Because they were imagining all manner of things. Does it mean we will disappear? Does it mean they were trying to picture that. And the next thing God did for man was to drive man, he drove man out of the Garden of Eden. I don't know what you have done that have made you fall out of favor. I don't know what you have done that have taken you away from your place. Am I talking to somebody here? It was not God that drove man directly, but technically the devil made man to fall out of grace and enter disgrace, and so man, grace that kept him in the garden expired. Can I preach to somebody here? I don't know where you ought to be that the enemy has made you leave that place. Today you are returning back there. If somebody is shouting that amen, a miracle is happening for that person. Am I talking to somebody here? You have lived a life of flourish. You have been flourishing. You have lived a life of blessing. You have lived a life of glory. But all of a sudden, you are now begging for food. This was you, a man of God, highly anointed, members coming to church, but now they are no longer coming. I don't know what have taken you away from your Eden. I don't know what have taken you away from the Garden of Eden. This was a family that was sweet. All of a sudden, because you don't have baby, there have been bitterness. I don't know what drove you out of your Garden of Eden. I don't know. This was you with a better job, but now there is no job. I don't know what took you out of your Garden of Eden. But today I have joined the host of heaven to intercede and to say, the yes, the canker worm, the palmer worm, and the caterpillar, and the locust has eaten, that they shall be restored. If you are there, shout that amen like thunder. If you are there, shout that amen like thunder. I see some restoration. I see some restoration. I see some recovery. I see some restoration. I see some recovery. Some of the things that you have lost, some of the things that have been taken away, you are about to recover them. The louder the amen, the quicker a miracle. Shabakata. The louder the amen, the quicker the miracle. I see you getting back your job. I see you getting back your twins. For the women that have gotten miscarriage, the years of miscarriage are over. The years of miscarriage are over. The years of loss, the years of disappointment are over. One man come to your life and live your life. Another one enter and live your life. I hear in my right ear, it is enough. It is enough. If you can shout that amen, you are recovering now. If you can shout that amen, you are taking over now. If you can shout that amen, you are taking over now. Shabaka parata, beka parata ba, inka parika ba, shabalika bala parata la biata, perika parata ba. If you can shout that amen, you are recovering now. Shout the amen like thunder. Shout it like thunder. Shout fire. Sit down. The Bible makes us to understand, one day Cain and Abel were asked by the Lord to make sacrifice. Abel was a keeper of sheep, and Cain, a farmer of crops. When it was time to offer their first fruits, that's why you must take first fruit, very important. When it was time to offer their first fruit, the Bible said Abel brought the firstling, the first of the animal, the best of the best. Why Cain brought so many crops but not the best? And the Lord said to him, I can't honor this sacrifice. And to show you how God was dealing with man, hear this, to show you how God was dealing with man, God will come to Adam in the cool of the evening, talk with Adam. So God now was dealing now the same way with the children of Adam. They were all having the same relationship
God will appear to them, talk to them in the cool. And so Cain was opportune to hear what God said to Abel and to also hear the comment God said about him. Then envy rose up. Jealousy. The greatest enemy of greatness is jealousy. Can I say this? Those people that will jealous you are not your enemy, they are your friends. Can I repeat it? People that will jealous you are familiar to you. They can be a family. Some of you think people who jealous you are from. No, they are people that are familiar. The first word jealousy started from family. So don't be surprised if your own blood fights you. Let's watch this. This is the first family on earth. The first example of Christian family. So I want you to sit down and meditate. The elder brother, God didn't favor Abel because he was the younger brother. God favored Abel because he did what was right. You are not favored because you are the last born or because you are the firstborn. You are not disfavored because you are the firstborn. You are disfavored because you are not doing what is right. And that's what is going on. Some of us, when we see God lift up somebody, we are angry because we feel we deserve it better than that person. It is very possible to pastor children as a spiritual father that envy you and wish you're dead. It is very possible to be in a family of seven and your success can become the reason why you're about to die. Your head has been declared, and the person that declared to kill you is from your family. From the word familiar. Nobody will jealous you without being familiar with you. Stop looking for people that are fighting you. Far, no. When God started lifting me up in ministry, some ministers who felt that I didn't deserve it, there's no kind of story they did not say about me. But you see, you can't use lie to overcome truth. The victory of lie over truth is for a moment. That somebody lies over you and say all manner of unthinkable things does not give him victory. I don't know how many of you are around Cain. There's a spirit I call the spirit of Cain. We will eat together. We will smile together. We will drink together. We will go to church together. But the guy is looking for a way to cut off my head. David said, if it were you, my enemy that fought me, I would have not been angry. If it were you that were fighting against me, I would have not been angry. He said, but it was you, my acquaintance. You that we went to the same fellowship together. That we entered the house of the Lord and the courtyard of the Lord. You are the one that have brought me to where. So many of you, your life had been tied up by some familiar enemy. They don't just like your guts. No matter how good you are, if God does not say Hami, amen to what you are doing, you can't prosper. Some of you are suffering because God favored you. I have one prayer point to pray for you. May your favor not cause you to die.
You didn't hear me well. May your favor not cause you to die. May your favor not cause you to die, oh. Because you are given an appointment in the church, may you not die because of that. Because you got a car, may you not die because of that. Because you were promoted, may you not die because of that. Because the blessing of the Lord maketh rich and addeth no sorrow.
See them? Four things the spirit of Cain will do. The spirit of Cain, number one, will be friendly with you. Number two, the spirit of Cain will invite you for a banquet. Number three, the spirit of Cain will never show you the bitterness. Number four, the spirit of Cain will allow you to be at the front so that they can backstab you from the back. Be very careful when somebody that is competing you all of a sudden say, I allow you to sit down. That seed has been cooked as a time bomb. You didn't hear me.
Cain was still in love with Abel and never showed any signal.
Was still in love with Abel, then invited him, let us go to the field together. Be very careful of people who never smile the day you were lifted up and all of a sudden are smiling with you after you are lifted up. You didn't hear me.
The day everybody is celebrating with me, you didn't celebrate. Your celebration came 1 month later. There is an afterthought. That celebration is not a celebration. It's a deception in order to make you feel we are on the same page so that they can carry out the assignment.
Now came and said, oh, let's go to the same field. And that's it. They went to the same field. While they were in the field, he allowed Abel now to stay at the front while he was at the back, so that he can pick something and hit him.
Somebody that used to feel, I am in charge, all of a sudden say, I am behind.
Something is wrong.
Sir, God was the one that technically caused the problem of Abel. I expected God to have struck Cain when Cain was about to kill Abel.
God told me, he said, when I favor you, you don't use wisdom, you will die foolishly.
God said to me, son, after I have favored you, I won't come down to defend the favor. I will give you, you have to now be wise to defend. If Abel was wise, number one, to know this overnight love that never existed from the beginning should be suspected, he wouldn't have followed Cain overnight. Can I say this? The problem that you have, you are too emotional. You are carried away by some crocodile tears. There are some people that can cry in front of you in order to kill you tomorrow.
The four ignorance of Abel. Number one was to love a jealous man. It's an ignorant spirit to love a man that is jealous of you. Any man jealous of you should not be loved. He's an enemy. And if you love him, be careful. When I'm talking about love, in other words, should not be loved, I'm not talking about you should not love everybody, but this one is an enemy.
Number two, ignorance of Abel is to bribe Cain, thinking that Cain will change. There are people you cannot change by trying to be good to them. The more you are good to them, you provoke them. They are already complaining that You are proving that you are wealthy. Then you took 2 million and gave to them. They will collect the 2 million and say, hey. So she's not saying that she has money. She's not giving me 2 million to prove to me that she's rich. They get provoked. The more you help them, they are provoked.
You can't bribe a frenemy. If you don't love me, go your way, I go my way.
Tell your neighbor, I am not Abel. I will not die like Abel. I'm sure. Why Cain was devising and scheming on how to kill Abel. God saw the heart of Cain. God knew what Cain was about to do. Now watch this. I thought God spoke to Abel. Why didn't God come down to speak to Abel? But I feel that the instinct of Abel have told Abel, this guy is about to kill you. But he refused to come in terms with that. That some of you here, you feel that we are too judgmental. Anytime we say, enemy of my father's house, die. You say, why are they saying die, die, die? Another problem of Abel was that he did not have a judgmental mentality. You must understand how to judge things and put them in context and out of context. Am I talking to somebody here? If you are not happy with me in the morning, you are not happy with me in the afternoon, you cannot be happy with me in the night. Because if you are around me in the night, you are about to keep me where nobody is there. Am I talking to somebody here? I am here to talk to some Abel that they have plucked your dead. They have looked for a way to kill you. I don't know how many of you that is around some Cain, extended family, relative, pastors of the same ministry, pastors of outside ministry, outside of church members. You were lifted up. They were not happy. They start talking about you, that you were not qualified, that you are not born again. Why were you giving praise and worship? Can I talk to somebody here? If the first spirit of the enemy entered into Cain, it can enter anybody. Am I talking to somebody? Stop praying against witch. The witch that is fighting you might be nest on the same room with you. The witch that is fighting you might be in your bedroom in the next bedroom. The witch that is fighting you can be in your father's house of the same father of the same mother. Am I talking to somebody here? Oh, that spirit of Cain, you cannot kill me because of my favor. I didn't decide my favor. He decided to lift me up. I didn't decide where I am. I came here by favor. You cannot dishonor me because God has honored me. Am I talking to somebody here? I don't know how long they have tried to kill you. I don't know those who are around your life. They have shattered your life. They have shattered your testimony. They have heard your story. They have gone around to talk about your story. They are still wondering. Despite what they have said, you are still shining. Despite what they have said, you are still rising. Despite what they have said, you are still soaring like an eagle. Can I say this? Am I talking to Abel here? May you not die, oh. May you not die, oh. May you not die. May you not die.
If God has not accepted the sacrifice of Abel and throw some accolades and commendation on that sacrifice, Abel wouldn't have died. Some of you, you are dying gradually because of the honor of God over your life. The position you occupied, to you it means nothing. But to them, it means something. You didn't hear me well. Some of you, you are under attack because of the car you just bought. You are under attack because of your gifts. You are under attack because you are anointed. You are under attack because you are better than them. You are under attack because they felt you shouldn't be able to do that thing you are doing. But you are doing it in their eye.
You are rising up as a king, and they are looking for a way to kill. The difference between Cain, between Abel and David, was that Abel was insensitive, but David was sensitive of the jealousy of Saul. My Saul, you can't kill me. The spirit of David is inside me. I am not like Abel. I am not like Abel. I am not like Abel. The Bible said why David was playing the javelin, why he was playing the harp. The Bible said he was still sensitive to dodge the arrow of Saul. Why? Because David understood the jealousy of Saul.
For Saul to kill David, he gave David an appointment to be close. Everyone that is jealous of you will not want you to be far from them, because they need to keep close mark on your achievement, on your greatness, on your impact. They need to get every single data of everything. There are some people after this service you should cut off your out of your life. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? Sit down. Watch this. I want to show you something now. When Cain killed Abel, Abel now died. When Abel now died, it was when Abel died that his blood started crying out for vengeance.
Father, I want to be alive and my blood is crying for vengeance. I want to be alive and my blood is crying for vengeance. I want to be alive and my blood is crying for vengeance. My blood is crying for vengeance. Why am I alive? I will not be dead and my blood crying for vengeance. Why am I alive? Let my blood cry for vengeance. Why am I alive? Let my blood cry for vengeance. Are you there? Enemy of your father, say fire. Enemy of your father. Enemy of your fathers, enemy of your mothers, fire. Enemy of your uncle, enemy of your business, fire. Enemy of your destiny, enemy of your greatness, wherever they are, shot fire.
Sit down.
God, if there is any time I need vengeance, it's not when I'm dead, it's when I'm alive. If there is any time I need vengeance, it's not when I'm dead, it's when I'm alive. He that dig the pit, let him fall into the pit. For there is no divinity, neither enchantment against Israel. Speak the word, for it shall not stand. For there is no weapon that is formed against Joshua Iginla that shall prosper. That every tongue that rise up against me in judgment, my yanda bayata yata, shall condemn, shatara bata. Am I talking to somebody here? Ladies and gentlemen, no wonder the Bible said the blood of Jesus speaketh more better thing than the blood of Abel. Do you know why? Because the blood of Jesus was speaking why it was alive. The blood was, it was not the blood of a dead man. It was the blood of a living man. It was not the blood of a dead man. The difference between the blood of Abel and the blood of Jesus was that the blood of Abel was the blood of a dead man speaking, but the blood of Jesus was the blood of a living man speaking. Father, let my blood speak while I'm alive. Let my blood speak while I'm alive. Let my blood speak while I'm alive. Oh God, let my blood speak while I'm alive. Fight against them that fight against me. Plead my cause. Fight against them that fight against me. Shut fire. Shut fire. Shut fire. I want to be alive and see them fall down. He said, the Lord said to my Lord, sit where I made your enemy thy footstool. It is when you are alive that you can make your enemy my footstool. I don't want to be in the grave and be told that's when God fights. No, God, I want to be alive and see them go to the graveyard.
I want to be alive and see them eat their own flesh. I want to be alive and see them being disgraced. I want to be alive and see them sink in the pit that they dug. I want to be alive and see a man fall into the gallows that he dug for me. Mordecai, you cannot die. You must have set the feet. Haman and the gallows. But because the God of Esther and Mordecai is alive, I want to be alive and see the king pass a decree where I'm a prime minister. Haman, you must go down. Am I prophesying here? Sapaka Barata, where you are alive, the enemy of your father will go down. Where you are alive, the enemy of your mother will go down. Am I talking here? The enemy of your ministry will go down. Hey, the blood of Jesus speaking more better thing. We are not of the blood of Abel, but we are of the blood of Jesus. We are of the blood of Jesus. The blood that speaks deliverance. The blood that speaks resurrection. The blood that speaks restoration. Somebody shall fire. Hey! Why should my blood speak when I'm dead? No. Oh, no. The blood that flows around my body. The blood that flows around the 206 bones in my body. I'm speaking to the blood. It is no longer the blood of Joshua Iginla. It's the blood of this risen Savior. I prophesy. They cannot kill me while you watch. Because there is a life in the blood. There is a language in the blood. I am not after the pattern of the blood of Abel. I am after the pattern of the blood of Jesus. I prophesy. Why am I alive? My blood will speak. When I'm talking about your blood, I'm talking about the blood of Jesus flowing in your body. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? What stop your father can't stop you. Today is Operation Judgment Day. Whatever kill your father cannot kill you. Wherever they gather, I prophesy by the aurora on my head. Shabata Balata. I prophesy by the aurora on my head. Your story changed. Your story changed. Hey! 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 Enough is enough. Enough is enough. I am not Abel. I belong to the Jesus generation. I am not Abel. I belong to the Jesus generation. Am I talking to somebody here? Oh my God. Plead my cause. Fight against those that fight against me. Plead my cause. Fight against those that fight against me. Oh God. Plead my cause. Fight against those that fight against me. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the spirit of the Lord shall raise up Ayada against them. I prophesy. Enough is enough.
Sit down, let me talk again. Shabalabata. Shabalabadaba. Pakataba. Paratata. It was the foolishness of Abel that made Abel to die. It was not part of God's plan. The guy didn't ask for vengeance. He was too loving to a fault until the day they put knife and killed him. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? We are in the days of prophetic violence, right from the days of John the Baptist. The kingdom of God suffered violence. The violent men shall take it by force. Am I talking to somebody here? I am not John the Baptist that you cut his head. I belong to the Jesus generation. Jesus said something. He said, nobody took my life. I was the one that laid it. And the same one that laid it can take it up. Am I talking to somebody here? I am preaching and prophesying from the prophetic blood from Calvary. That blood that was not killed. That blood that was not dead. That blood that is bigger than an ocean. That blood that does not run blood. I prophesy. Sit down.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible makes us to understand that after that, after Abel died, it now dawned on Adam and Eve. Oh, we talked
We were the one that was supposed to die. Because Abel, Adam and Eve, they guide their loins. They were wondering, we were the one that committed sin. We are the one that was supposed to die. But rather than we die, our offspring died. That some of you are dying the death of somebody. Because God told us that the day we eat of the fruit in the middle of the garden, that we are going to die. But we did not die. It was Abel that died instead of us. In fact, it's one of our committed sons that died. Then God began to make me to understand that when you are around a general, you must make sure you guide your loins. You must make sure you are wise like the general. When you are around a lion, don't be an elephant. When you are around a lion, don't be a puppy. When you are around a lion, don't be a cat. When you are around a lion, don't be a snake. But because when you become a snake, you become a prey. Because there's something I call Passover. What is supposed to happen to me? Passover. And that's why lion give back to lion. When you're a pastor under a pastor, you behave like your father. Your father cannot be a lion and you're a cat. If you're a cat, you become a prey. Am I talking to somebody here? So the death that Adam was supposed to die, the death that Eve was supposed to die, came on Abel. Then I asked myself the question, Abel was not there when Eve committed the offense. Abel was not there when Adam committed the offense. But Abel had to die because God said the soul that sinned shall die. But I prophesy, Shabakata, I prophesy, you will not die another man's death. Ladies and gentlemen, you will not suffer for the sin you didn't commit. How did I know that? The Bible speaking to us in the book of Genesis. God spoke to Eve, for the seed of you, woman, shall bruise the head of the serpent. So immediately the devil heard, the seed of Eve shall bruise the head of the serpent. He felt it must be Abel. Now watch this. Watch this. The two children were alive, and both of them were dead to Eve.
How did I know?
Abel died. Cain
became a vagabond, was sent out of the house. He became like a madman. So it was too loss to a mother with dear children. So it will make you understand the value of that text now.
Abel died. Adam didn't even quarrel Abel.
And of course, they must have had arguments in the family. But that's not it.
God took side
with Cain. Oh God, I know you are in heaven hearing me. Lord, don't take side for me when I'm dead. Take side for me when I'm alive. You didn't hear me well.
Lord, if there's any time you should arise, now. Don't arise when I'm dead. Arise now.
Do you know why? It's not the fault of God. Psalm 68 verse 1 says, let God arise. He didn't say God will arise. He said allow me to arise.
You are the one that did not allow me to arise. That's why I did not arise. He didn't say God will arise. He said let him arise. God is boiling and say allow me to judge them. And you are so cool and psychedelic and gentle. That's why I say if you are gentle, you cannot be settled. Allow him to arise. The lion of the tribe of Judah said, Joshua, Iginla, come up for road. You say, no, I want to fight. He said, allow me to arise. They have scattered your business. They have stopped your womb. Allow me to arise. If you don't invite him to the party, he will not come.
Love is the true meaning of life. If you must live a life of divinity, you must operate in love. The Love Generation is a book by Brother Joshua Iginla, that will guide you to living the practical life of Christ. Get a copy now. For more inquiry, call the numbers now showing on your screen. Marriage is God's own institution. Therefore, every man and woman need to understand their differences and how to work together to build a home. Oh Lord, help my marriage. By God's servant, Brother Joshua Iginla, is a classical that will give you an in-depth understanding of an ideal marriage. Get a copy now. For more inquiry, call the numbers now showing on your screen.